I was sure when I was meeting extraordinary objects that first of all I need to buy it and after to learn what it was. It's not in the school you can learn, it's not because you have read a book.
Being born in such a family, you get lucky enough to be exposed very young. And I was feeling at the time that contemporary would be more free or more open than antiques. You can believe that antiques are a bit stuffy or a bit old. If you look around you, you'll have some Oriental piece, some French piece, some Italian piece, some 17th century, some 18th century. It's a completely wide range, and slowly I realized actually it was even more open than working with contemporary because I'm able to do whatever I feel. We were young with my brother. We had a bit of experience, but rather with a contemporary world, with emerging and living artists. And that was, I felt, a great experience to start working with people and having the context of the art trying to communicate your passion. In our field now, it's even more exciting to me because you have first your discovery, your passion, which excites you, then the understanding of what is your discovery, and then the communication of your passion. So it's, you know, three phases which are very exciting.